shouldn't be here. You're a menace. Your mooring line broke because it's frayed through.
I'm sorry. I didn't know.
Wake up, lady. Get with it.
Zane, don't be rude. Give the lady a chance to speak.
This old bag's boat broke free and hit mine. It put a scratch on my cowling. Look.
I said I'm sorry.
She said she's sorry.
It's not going to pay for the damage, is it? I bet she doesn't even have insurance. This boat shouldn't even be here. It's an embarrassment.
Zane, you're overreacting even for you.
Am I? We'll see what the harbour master thinks.
Don't worry, he's all talk.
Thank you, Emma. Come aboard.
Lady Cleo always talks about.
It's nice to be talked about.
She never told me you lived on a boat.
I didn't tell her I was a Capricorn either. But that's another tale. Oh, I'm sorry. I've made you uncomfortable. I'm not a very good host. Mind you, I haven't had anyone else on board the Lorelei for 23 years.
Miss Chatham!
Mr. Hendricks, would you care for some iced tea?
You know why I'm here, Miss Chatham. Another complaint's been received.
People seem to complain so much these days.
A regularity which is hard to ignore when they concern you.
I'll take that as a compliment. You care about me. Lovely.
Are you going to evict her or what?
Leave this to me. Miss Chatham, we've spoken on many occasions. On the last occasion, I reminded you of unpaid mooring fees that go back 5 years.
No, I don't recall that.
Before that, you'd been served with several requests to maintain your vessel according to regulations.
I really must open those letters. I've been meaning to read them.
You're getting evicted, lady. You're gone.
Do you mind? I'm handling this.
Well, hurry it up.
Why are you doing this?
Now, we've been pretty patient with Miss Chatham over the years. Time has come for us to act.
You can't throw her out. You'll be all right. Do you want me to come to the hospital with you?
They want my treasure.
Just try to rest.
Don't let them get my treasure.
I didn't mean to give the old biddy a heart attack.
Maybe you should tell her that. The ambulance guy said it could have been more serious. She stopped taking her medication.
Poor lady.
Her name's Miss Chatham.
Is she that weird old lady that lives on the boat?
Yeah, that's her.
How do you know her?
No, I don't. I've just heard about her. She lives on that leaky old wreck. No friends, no family, all alone.
She's the one that seems to know all about the full moon and our powers and our tales.
Some people say she's a witch.
And if they said she was an Easter bunny, would you believe that?
There was a time I didn't believe in mermaids either.
Where's Emma?
I'm not sure. She just said she was going out for a while.
All right. We said we'd all meet here, but that's all right. No hurry. I can fill in time.
Sounds like her now.
It's about time. Where have you been?
Don't stare. It's rude. This is Miss Chatham. Miss Chatham, this is...
You must be Rikki.
Yeah. Mum, we've got a house guest. The hospital discharged Miss Chatham. She'll be fine if she takes her medication and gets some rest. I thought this would be a good place for that, okay?
That'll be fine, darling. Hello, I'm Lisa.
I don't want to be a bother, but Emma insisted she can be very strong-willed.
Yes, I've noticed. Could we have a word, please?
Sure.
You should have asked, Em.
You would have said no. Mum, she needs our help.
She's homeless.
Yes, but there are welfare agencies that look after people in her situation. They're not alone.
But she is alone. That's why she's homeless.
Sorry I'm late, I...
Hello, Cleo.
Oh. Hi.
All right. Miss Chatham, if you'd like to come with me, I'll show you to the spare room.
Oh, you're very kind. Your natural hair colour.
You brought her here? What can I do? The harbour master wants to move her boat from the marina. He says she can't stay there.
But you brought her here?
Just for a while. We'll try and talk to the harbour master. Make him see some reason.
Emma, this old lady knows about us. What if she says something to your mum or dad?
She won't. She's smart and I'm sure she's discreet.
You hope?
Look, Cleo, we're probably worrying about nothing. I mean, has she ever actually said to you, I know you're a mermaid?
Not in those words exactly. But everything she said about the full moon turned out to be true. Didn't it?
My husband and I bought that boat many, many years ago now. He died about 15 years ago.
You must be like 100 years old then.
Elliot.
Not quite. Still, I couldn't get rid of the Lorelei. We had so many happy memories on her. Oh, look, Emma's back. She knows a lot about the water.
Oh, I don't think so. I don't swim competitively anymore.
Right, not competitively. Still, the Lorelei has served me well. If I had to start her, I'm sure the motor will start.
And what if it doesn't?
Well, you just have to make the water work for you. Right, Cleo?
What? Oh, no, I wouldn't know.
Hello. Yeah?
Gracie.
You. It's the harbour master.
Now she's getting phone calls here.
Hello? What? But you can't. Well, no, but you can't.
What is it?
They're taking my boat away from me. I can't use it anymore. It doesn't meet with their silly regulations. It's all I've got and they're taking it away.
Rikki, it's her home. I've got to help her.
You're kidding.
It's a pile of junk. Coat of paint will spruce it up. Now stop arguing and start painting.
It needs more than paint. It needs a new boat.
Rikki being negative. What a surprise.
Get real. We can't do this.
And even if you did, it's not going to make a difference. I know you're trying to help, but you're wasting your time. The boat's got rust all through its structural framework. Do I need to go on? She's better off without it.
That is your opinion, not mine. I'll be leaving now. Thank you.
You know you can't do that. I've referred this matter on. The boat has been impounded by the water police. It's not seaworthy.
It's my home. I live here.
Miss Chatham, they're just doing what they think is right. They're trying to help.
I've got to get my things. They're just after my treasure.
The paint job cost a few hundred, so the jet ski looks as good as new.
Let's just go home. Back to my place. We'll talk about it there.
I want what's mine. They're after my treasure. All of them.
What do you mean by treasure? No idea.
That was delicious.
Well, I can't take all the credit. This was Miss Chatham's recipe for clam chowder.
Well, it was brilliant.
Well, thank you. I'll help you clean up.
Oh, no, nonsense. Cleo, could you help get Miss Chatham nice and comfortable on the sofa, please? And don't forget to take your medication. Darling, you know that I love having her here, but you realise this can't go on indefinitely.
I know, Mum.
You did the right thing helping her, but she needs her own place, a permanent home.
Just a few more days.
Then what?
Friendship. That's the most important thing. I appreciate what you're trying to do for me, but the burden you carry is too great to carry alone.
Wait, what burden? Oh, that one.
When you're different, it helps if you have friends who understand. I had friends.
Did they dress like you?
This was long ago. We were younger. I wasn't always this old. Or maybe I was.
When you say burden, what do you mean?
When it got too great for me, I had to give it up.
You can do that.
It's getting late. I think we should all be in bed.
But it was just starting to get interesting.
Yeah.
Miss Chatham's right. It's late.
Good night, girls.
Would you like me to show you to your room?
Oh, it's all right. I know where I'm going.
See you tomorrow, Miss Chatham.
You miss me? All right, Lorelei. Don't fail me now.
Elliot, have you seen Miss Chatham? She's not in her room and her things are gone.
What's this? That old bat. She did this.
Zane, you don't know that.
Yes, I do. Right. That's how she wants to play it? She doesn't know who she's messing with.
Boat and I need you to drive it.
Good girl. We're making good time.
Jet ski. You're not getting away with it.
You can't swim because...
Zane's out there chasing her. He'd see me. Hurry up, Lewis.
You stay away from me.
Forget it, mate. Don't even try.
Don't get excited. I want compensation. You wrecked my jet ski. I want money.
I don't have any.
Don't lie to me. You've got treasure here, somewhere.
can't have that.
Can't I? Just watch me. There's the Lorelei. Look, near the Mako Island mangroves.
He's already here.
It wasn't my fault. I didn't do anything. She's still breathing.
Zane, there's got to be some pills down there. Go and have a look. Did you find anything? Come on, Zane. She needs to get in Lewis's boat. She needs a hospital.
I know.
Zane, if she dies now, it'll be your fault. Thanks, Zane. Come on, let's go. Check in.
She'll be all right. I'm staying.
Zane, if you touch any of her things...
I'll catch up.
There isn't time to argue. Let's go.
You can't. He'll know your secret.
She doesn't have a choice. Do you, Emma?
Make sure she gets to the hospital, Lewis.
Stay with her.
I can't. You need a doctor.
It's all right. You floated up. I dragged you to shore.
But I went down. I couldn't get out.
Somehow you did. You were lucky.
There was something down there. Something, I don't know. Did you see anything?
No.
Yeah? Well, I saw something. And I'm gonna find out exactly what it was.
I've got something for you. My treasure. You found it. It wasn't easy. It's pretty dark down there now. I'm sorry about the Lorelei.
It was 1955. I'm the one on the left.
I thought so.
And Julia and Gracie.
Where are they now?
Gone. Thank you. This means more to me than anything.
I've got the retirement village on the line. There's a vacancy if you want it.
Well, you've done more than enough for me. I'm sure I like it there.
She'll take it.
But I will miss the excitement.
I bet you will.